quick break?
Nothing's good, the news is bad.
This is William Eastman, managing partner for GrowthWorks Media and station director for IBGR. One of my jobs is finding great on-air talent, consultants and business owners with presence and a story to tell. We're expanding our broadcast team to represent our four core time zones, North America, Australia, New Zealand, Singapore, and the Philippines, the India subcontinent, and the last of four, United Kingdom, Ireland, Europe, and Africa. If you are a small business consultant or business owner and would like to audition for an on-air slot in our six-hour show cycle, contact the station director, and that is at programming@bgr.network. We will respond to your email within one business day. Thanks for listening, and don't miss this great opportunity to put the world back to work and grow with us. Thanks.
Is your CRM making your business grow? When surveyed, about 90% of business leaders admit that their CRM isn't. The most common cause for that? Salespeople don't use their CRM the way they should. Why not? Well, it takes them too much time and discipline to fill out their CRM completely, and if salespeople don't, the CRM system becomes useless. That's why when we started Salesware, we asked ourselves, what if we build a CRM system that fills out itself? What if we build a system that surfaces existing data so that you know and remember all about your customers and never forget and disappoint another lead? That's what Salesware does today. It pulls in all the data buried in your emails, email signatures, calendar, phone, social data, company database, email and web tracking, and offers it to you in an easy way so you and your CRM are always up to date. Want to see this for yourself? Head to salesware.com and get your free trial.
Is a child of God, wife, mother, and grandmother. She was born and raised in Panama City, Florida, before moving to Fayetteville, North Carolina, at the age of 23. She is the lead HERZ architect trademark and supports leaders' elevation to the pinnacle, respect, leadership level, while strategizing team effectiveness and productivity. She specializes in helping women in leadership harmonize family and work life, while developing dynamic and productive teams. She is a dynamic, high-powered professional with a results-charged career in growth and leadership. Her purpose in life is to transform the lives of others by inspiring, equipping, and growing. Her mission in life is to provide leaders with the tools required to ignite an intentional growth mindset that will drive behavior to achieve actionable results of personal value. Her vision is to see women reach their full potential, remove obstacles and knowledge gaps, and lead their life versus just living their life. Find out more about Dr. Lashley at drtracylashley.info. Dr. Lashley is also the President and Chief Elevation Officer, CEO, of the Leaders Innovative Growth Solutions LLC, where her primary focus is leadership, personal growth, and development. She is also an Executive Director for the John Maxwell Team. Dr. Lashley is the founder of Bossed Up Lead HERZ, Inc., a nonprofit organization, where the mission is to eliminate stereotypes amongst women and girls in the workplace, schools, and communities, while providing a sanctuary to produce intentional growth, success, and significance. The 501c3 organization also generates essential resources to elevate women and girls to an entrepreneurial mindset and executive leadership. Learn more by going to bossdupleaderz.org. She is also an international business radio show host for two shows, Women of Business Thriving and Heartfelt Leader SHIFTS, and also co-hosts Thrive Talk with TKT. She co-authored five best-selling books, Becoming the Shiro, the new female leader, courageous enough to lead, the professional woman, pivoting to a new normal, and women inspiring nations I'm still standing and contributed to One Habit for Entrepreneurial Success with Forbes Riley and Les Brown. She is managing her own anthology project for a One Habit of the World's Greatest Leaders. She is also writing a solo book for team building. Find out more about Dr. Lashley at drtracylashley.info.
Hello, hello, hello. We are back. This is Dr. Tracy Hines Lashley, and you are listening to Women of Business Thriving on the IBGR Network. If you have not done so, I want you to go download the app. It is so simple. Go to your app store, IBGR, boom. You have it. Click on it, download it. So we are doing a season review of Women of Business Thriving. And if you did not listen to this one, it was aired on November the 6th, and it was Power of Being a Woman in Business. So during this episode, I talked a lot about, you know, the reasons that, you know, business owners need, you know, women in their business, and as well as some of the top 10 things that women should know. So this show, I talked about 9 reasons why your business need women in order to be successful. And at the top was women tend to be focused and organized. Okay, men, I'm not saying that you are not, but women just do this a little bit better. So your business needs to have a woman. And a lot of times we bring an angle that you may not have thought about in your, you know, organization. We might have some systems that could assist you in being better. So we're not saying that you're not good now, but we elevate you. And another thing is, women are often good at managing stress. Okay, we run, you know, our families, the children, I'll say that. When we have children and then we have a spouse, we have to know how to manage stress. And then when you add on being an entrepreneur, I say we are pretty good at it. Not all of us are, but for the most part, we, you know, we do a little bit better than men. And women often collaborate and work really hard. A lot of times we don't collaborate as much as we should with other women, but we do with men. And what this gives you is an area where we know how to network. We know how to create dynamic teams. So these are areas that you need in your business. And I will say that there are times where you just don't want to do that. You don't want to collaborate with anyone. Sometimes, especially with men, they're like, I don't need that. I can remember so many times I was riding down the road, you know, with my husband driving, and he's lost and did not want to say that he was lost, but I knew he was lost. He didn't want to ask for directions. I'm like, come on, are you serious? We're going to just ride around? I know where I'm going. Do you really? They would not ask for directions. And that same, you know, mindset can spill over into business. I don't need anyone else. Well, you do. And women, we will remind you of this. And also, women tend to get results. Yeah, because we know how to talk to people. And sometimes we are more, you know, relatable. People can relate to us, and because we're the motherly type. Now, some of us are kind of hard, so yeah. But for the most part, we are. People want to talk to us, and they'll come to us with their problems. And also, many women are pro-customer. Yes. We are all about our customers. And when the customers feel like they're a part of your organization, of your business, whoo, they will keep coming back. Why is that? Can you imagine going somewhere, going into a business, a store, and you're not greeted? No one even acknowledges you. They walk right past you. Would you keep going back? This is a better question. Would you purchase something there? I know I wouldn't. I have gone to so many car dealerships and I wasn't greeted. And I do something that a lot of people may not do, but I do this intentionally. I will go to a car lot looking like I have no money. And I do that on purpose. I know you're probably like, why would she do that? Yeah, I do that. Because if you can't greet me, you know, as a customer with money, regardless of what I have in my pockets, I don't want to purchase from you. I have actually been to a car lot several times and there were people who just looked past me like, she can't afford this. And then there'll be some who, you know, come right up to me, ask how, you know, how they can help me, what I'm looking for. And guess what? I drive right off the lot and look right at the person who did not want to serve me. And a lot of times men are bad at that. they will, oh yeah, I'm not going to waste my time. But women, we love to talk and we're chit-chatting. How can I help you? And there have been cases where women don't walk up to women. They're just like, yeah, well, I don't want to talk to a woman today. Or I'm not going to just, you know, entertain that. But as for the most part, women, we're pro-customer and we will, you know, treat you with respect and make you want to return. And another aspect, I'm not going to go through all of them because I want you to listen to the, you know, podcast. Women are great listeners. And that's one thing your customers really want. They want to be listened to. Okay. I use a car dealership because there are so many times I've gone to the dealer and heard people just yabber, 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 da, da, da. You know, I'm like, oh my goodness, will they stop talking? And the salesperson is just right there and they're just so engaged with them and they're listening to them and they're, you know, seeing what they need and what they like to do and having, you know, what makes you tick and, you know, what, you know, drives you to purchase basically. And if you've taken DISC, you know that different personalities purchase in different ways. And so if you have not taken a DISC assessment and you have your team haven't taken it, and also EIQ, there's a emotional intelligence, you know, DISC as well, you know, reach out to me and let's talk. Let's have your team be a part of that and grow and thrive together by knowing how to communicate with each other. And another aspect that I want to go over really quickly before we go take a break, things that women need to know. We need to know how to build a network of powerful people, not just anyone, but the right people. We also want to find a sponsor, not just a mentor, someone who will sponsor you and say, hey, yeah, I think you need to, you know, collaborate with this person or hire this person because they do really great work. And also seek out organizations with senior women. And also ask for frequent and objective feedback. You want to know how you've been doing. And this will help and develop a strategy for effectively handling feedback. And a couple more things I want you to do is choose a business partner wisely. You have to choose one. You have to select one. And avoid organizations that reward FaceTime. Let's take a quick break and we will be